SpaceX completed the wet dress rehearsal of Ship 29 and Booster 11. Elon Musk revealed the next Starship launch timeline. Blue Origin resumes crewed New Shepard suborbital flights. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Welcome back. So today, we have good news that you all have been waiting for. SpaceX achieved a significant milestone in its Starship program by conducting a successful wet dress rehearsal, WDR, at the Starbase test site in Boca Chica, Texas. This crucial test brings the vehicle one step closer to its orbital launch attempt. The WDR test is a critical milestone for the Starship program, verifying the full launch countdown sequence and the performance of the vehicle and orbital pad for flight-like operations. The test began around 6 a.m. with SpaceX opening and lowering the chopsticks into the launch position, followed by the tower vent becoming visible. Later, at 8:55 a.m., the propellant load began, with frost lines appearing around the prototypes. By 9:30 a.m., both the ship and booster were fully loaded with liquid oxygen and methane propellants. The wet dress rehearsal test was completed by 11 a.m., followed by a depressed vent. Since some of you are new to the space community, you may be wondering what is wet dress rehearsal. Don't worry, I will explain in the best possible way I can. Let's start with the first term, wet, which refers to the presence of propellants, in this case, liquid oxygen and methane, which are loaded into the vehicle's propellant tanks. The dress rehearsal part of the term indicates that the test simulates the actual launch countdown sequence, but without actually launching the vehicle. So, is this procedure really important before launching? Of course it is. WDR test is a crucial step in the preparation for launch, as it verifies the functionality of the vehicle's systems, including the propulsion, electrical, and avionics systems. You know, it also tests the interactions between the vehicle and the launch pad, ensuring that everything is working as expected. Anyways, today's successful WDR test marks a significant step, and this test is one of the final procedures before the orbital launch attempt, along with a static fire test of all 33 Raptor engines in the Super Heavy booster, which SpaceX attempted last month. Elon Musk recently shared on X that the next test flight is likely to occur within 3 to 5 weeks, with the objective of getting the ship past max heating, or further than last time. I think we may see a launch date within 2-3 days, probably for the next week, or by the first week of June. I am really excited for this launch, and I can definitely say that their turnover period after each launch is getting short. This is really cool when comparing the size and the immense complexity involved within the entire system. Also, have you ever felt that SpaceX is trying to push the Starship's orbital launch attempts almost like the Falcon 9's? I really like to hear your opinions on this. So, there is the comment box way down. Share it there. NASA is closely following SpaceX's Starship tests, having provided over $4 billion in awards through its Human Landing System, HLS program, to develop versions of Starship for lunar exploration. The agency is impressed by the scale and progress of the Starship development, with Ryan Joyce of NASA's Langley Research Center stating, "We are literally trying to launch skyscrapers here." NASA's insight into Starship development includes having astronauts visit to ensure the vehicle's safe operation. The agency's involvement in the Starship program is crucial, as it will play a vital role in NASA's Artemis lunar exploration campaign. The Starship vehicle is expected to land astronauts on the moon, and NASA is working closely with SpaceX to ensure the vehicle meets the necessary safety and operational requirements. The HLS program has provided significant funding to SpaceX to develop the necessary technology and capabilities for lunar missions. As SpaceX conducts Starship tests at Boca Chica, it is also constructing a new Starship launch facility on the grounds of Launch Complex 39A at the Kennedy Space Center. The tower for this launch pad now overshadows the existing pad used for Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy launches. This new facility will provide a dedicated launch site for Starship missions, enabling SpaceX to launch its vehicles more efficiently and effectively. The construction of the new launch facility is a significant investment by SpaceX, demonstrating its commitment to the Starship program and its long-term goals. As you all know, the SpaceX is working towards establishing a permanent human settlement on Mars, and the Starship vehicle is a critical component of this plan. The Starship program is a revolutionary effort, aiming to reduce launch costs and increase launch rates. The vehicle's reusable design and advanced propulsion system make it an attractive option for NASA and other customers. In conclusion, we are on the edge of witnessing another historic orbital launch of the Starship Super Heavy. The only remaining step is the official announcement from SpaceX, which is expected to reveal the launch date. It's been nearly 3 months since the last test flight, and the anticipation is building once again. With the successful completion of the wet dress rehearsal, the launch site is set for the highly anticipated orbital launch, and I can't wait to see the Starship Super Heavy take to the skies. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content.
On May 19th, Blue Origin's new Shepard spacecraft successfully completed its first crewed mission in nearly 2 years, carrying six people, including the first American astronaut candidate, on a suborbital spaceflight. The mission, designated NS-25, lifted off from Blue Origin's launch site 1 in West Texas at 10:35 a.m. Eastern, following a brief delay due to a technical issue. The countdown was held for more than 20 minutes at the T-minus minute mark for an unspecified technical issue, but the vehicle's ascent appeared to go as planned. The spacecraft's propulsion module landed safely under rocket power at a pad near the launch site, marking a successful return to flight for the new Shepard program. However, one of the three parachutes on the crew capsule did not fully inflate during the descent. Although company officials assured that the capsule is designed to land safely with only two parachutes, the capsule touched down safely, and all six crew members were reported to be in good condition. The NS-25 mission featured Ed Dwight, a 90-year-old former U.S. Air Force pilot and the first American black astronaut candidate, who was selected by the Kennedy administration in 1961. Although he did not fly to space at the time, he has now achieved this milestone thanks to Space for Humanity, a nonprofit organization that arranges flights for individuals on commercial spacecraft. Dwight expressed his excitement and gratitude after the flight, calling it a life-changing experience. He added, "I thought I didn't need it in my life, but I lied." The mission's elapsed time was 9 minutes and 53 seconds, slightly shorter than previous full-duration New Shepard flights. The spacecraft reached a peak altitude of approximately 106 kilometers, consistent with previous flights. This mission marked the first time New Shepard carried people since the NS-22 mission in August 2022. The program experienced a setback in September 2022, when the NS-23 flight suffered an engine problem, triggering the crew capsule's abort motor. Although the capsule landed safely, the propulsion module was destroyed. An investigation revealed a structural failure of the nozzle of the vehicle's B3PM engine, requiring design changes. New Shepard returned to flight in December 2023 with the NS-24 mission, a reflight of the payload-only NS-23 mission. Company officials had announced plans to resume crewed flights soon, but did not provide a specific timeline. Despite the parachute issue, the NS-25 mission was deemed a success, demonstrating the reliability and safety of the new Shepard spacecraft. The mission's success is a significant milestone for Blue Origin, which has been working towards establishing a commercial spaceflight capability. The new Shepard spacecraft is designed to carry six people to suborbital space, providing a brief experience of weightlessness and a view of the Earth's curvature. The spacecraft's propulsion module is powered by a B3PM engine, which is capable of producing 110,000 pounds of thrust. The crew capsule is equipped with a pusher abort motor, which can quickly separate the capsule from the propulsion module in case of an emergency.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.